Michael Quill. He's Pat McAfee from Friday Night SmackDown on Fox. Happy New Year, everybody. And breaking news tonight, at 6 o'clock Eastern, the WWE issued a press release that claims that Brock Lesnar will now compete for the WWE Championship, which is represented, of course, on Monday Night Raw, in a fatal five-way match tonight. That is because the Universal Champion from SmackDown, Roman Reigns, sent out a tweet a bit earlier today, which said this. Roman Reigns saying that he tested positive for COVID-19, and because of the protocols around COVID-19, will not be able to compete and defend his title here tonight.
That son of a bitch COVID has done a lot to our world. Tonight, on day one, the first premium live event of 2022, we don't get a chance to see the GOATs, but Brock said he is still hungry for a championship.
And he has the opportunity against Owens, the champion Big E, Rollins, Lashley, Lesnar, fatal five-way for the WWE title. And it is fight night in Atlanta. And his protege.
Ring forward. The following contest is a tag team match scheduled for 1-4. Introducing first, the team of Rich Holland and Sheamus.
Rich Holland and Sheamus have made quite the team here in WWE over the past couple of months. The WWE Universe still filing into what will be a sold-out State Farm Arena in Atlanta tonight for WWE Day 1. Pat, I want to take you back to the 12 Days of Christmas Gauntlet match back on Christmas Eve. The winner to receive an opportunity at Shinsuke Nakamura and the Intercontinental Championship. One of the matches, Cesaro against his rival Sheamus. Ridge Holland would provide a distraction.
Ridge Holland, a chip off the old block, says Sheamus, distracts Cesaro, who was making quite a run. And Sheamus,
hey,
fight night, like Migos in Atlanta, knocks Cesaro out.
And thanks to Rich Holland, Cesaro is taken out of the gauntlet match. What a revenge on this man's mind.
I'd say.
With Sheamus, formed one of the great tag teams of the last 20 years, known as The Bar. Tonight, he's a bitter rival with a Celtic Warrior.
His partner is electrified.
Talking about the 12 Days of Christmas gauntlet match back on Christmas Eve. What a performance for Ricochet in that gauntlet match. It would be Ricochet versus Sheamus in one of the matchups on that Friday night. And as Ricochet was...
Whatever the case, Ridge and Sheamus have been on the exact same page since they came on here together.
Ricochet,
yeah, go ahead.
With an incredible gutsy effort in the gauntlet match, which would fall in the end to Sami Zayn, who would eventually go on to win and earn an opportunity at Nakamura in the Intercontinental title.
Tonight, but Cesaro...
It's not tonight.
Oh, jeez.
I know you're getting ahead of yourself.
Follow the product, dude.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, about 23 minutes left till we head to the first premium live event of 2022. That would be WWE Day 1.
This man right here is your replacement.
Tag made. Here comes the 6'1", 253-pounder from Yorkshire, England. Ridge Holland.
Sheamus told Cesaro, this is your replacement, The Bar. One of the all-time great tag teams. Now they're bitter enemies.
You know, Pat, when we were showing you that footage from a couple of weeks ago, you noticed that Cesaro's midsection was heavily taped. That was after the attack with a billy club by Ridge Holland.
Yeah, now that no longer have any taped up on her ribs, had a good holiday season, it's 2022, and Cesaro looks
powerful as ever.
And
look at Cesaro
just moving this guy around
and staring right back at Sheamus with a backbreaker.
He was just picking him up and throwing him around like he was a...
And now the double team by Ricochet and Cesaro. That hurt. Cover by Ricochet and a kick out by Holland. That was incredible. Ricochet can do some amazing things.
Especially when he's got the Swiss Superman throwing him around. Boot to face. Did you see that?
Rich Holland somehow able to kick out. Backs a Ricochet into the corner. And now the Celtic Warrior Sheamus makes the tag.
That's because Rich Holland needs metal, dude.
Sheamus, a former multi-time world champion. And Ricochet fighting back. He still blames Sheamus. The cheap shot he took on Ricochet for costing Ricochet an opportunity to win the gauntlet match. Oh!
As he should. He was on a run there. And then Sheamus comes in and ruins it. Ricochet's been trying to get to the top of the WWE for some time. A lot of people say he deserves it. Sheamus is trying to stop him. Now Ricochet on day one has a chance to say, Sheamus, go to hell.
And the sliding leg drop cover now by Ricochet. And a kick out. Ricochet so exciting to watch, fast paced, needs to keep that pace quick, Pat, in order to have an opportunity to knock off Sheamus here tonight.
Ricochet can fly around so fast, and I do believe fire would start. That's not actual flames on his pants, but look at the power of Ricochet.
Yeah, but an elbow by Sheamus stops Ricochet in his tracks.
It's a bad idea by Ricochet, I think. I mean, I've never succeeded in the ring, so I'd be speaking out of pocket for that, but he should have kept flying. Now he kind of lends the advantage to Sheamus here, a little ground and pound.
Yeah, exactly what a Sheamus...
Why would you try to pick him up there?
...wanted to do, and that would be slow Ricochet down. Meanwhile, I believe that Rich Holland may have a busted nose after that move by Ricochet. He's being attended to by a trainer at ringside as Sheamus continues on in this matchup. Oh. And Sheamus with the Irish Curse backbreaker!
I mean, we don't have the medical tent here for sure, but Sheamus has to know. He's probably going at it alone right now. And Sheamus doesn't care.
No, not at all. He's completely dominating Ricochet. Another look at the impact of the spine.
Sheamus loves having all the spotlight. All the
Sheamus is, and I've said this before, one of the most underrated superstars in WWE history, Pat.
I'm just too strong.
He's a multi-time world champion. He's won Money in the Bank and the Royal Rumble. Former King of the Ring.
He also has a mental edge over everybody because everybody that steps in the ring with him knows that you're getting in there with a pub brawler.
Yeah, indeed. One of the most physical competitors in WWE today. But Ricochet is not going to take that. Ricochet now fighting back. Sheamus now dropping Ricochet down. Cover, hook of the leg. Is this enough? And Ricochet gets the shoulder up.
Sheamus locking Ricochet in. A little bit of a recliner here. Old school.
And if Sheamus continues to work on Ricochet, we've got an update now on Rich Holland. Holland may have a broken nose. He fell out of the ring after this happened. The double team now by Cesaro and Ricochet. Now watch this.
Perfectly placed boot to face.
Yes, and that boot opened up Rich Holland. Holland would roll out of the ring. He was attended to for a couple of minutes by our ringside physicians, and now has been taken back to the locker room area for further attention. So Sheamus now finds himself in a two-on-one situation.
Staring down an old tag team partner here, asking Atlanta, are you not entertained?
And Sheamus does not seem to be worried at all over the fact that he finds himself in a very awkward position here.
How about the first day of 2022? Sheamus is now in a handicap match against Ricochet and Cesaro.
Yeah, imagine if he knocks off Cesaro and Ricochet here tonight.
I don't think anybody would have a better start to 2022.
And the 10 beats of a battering by Sheamus.
He's holding Ricochet's lifeless body up by his head. Down goes Ricochet with 10 beats on a battering.
And we are being told,
don't need it. Jamie said, I don't need a tag partner. Well, with an Irish accent.
His tag partner will not return to this match. He is being treated for what we are calling a broken nose. That's what medical officials are telling us as Sheamus continues to try to put Ricochet away, and Ricochet now fighting back.
Sheamus said, let's do another one. Ricochet said, not so fast, my friend.
Tornado DDT, and Ricochet with an opportunity. And how sweet it would be for Cesaro to knock off his old partner Sheamus tonight.
This would be the second thing associated with Ireland that would crumble whenever they were in the lead. Notre Dame earlier, now Sheamus potential.
And Cesaro now, the Swiss Superman, unloading on his former bar colleague Sheamus.
European uppercut.
And is the uppercut train.
Another one.
Oh. Cesaro dropping Sheamus over the top rope.
Got Cesaro by himself in a little predicament there. Found his balance. Tosses the big red-headed Irishman outside.
And Cesaro now with a running uppercut into the barricade.
The vascularity on Cesaro is outrageous. This man is chiseled like a Greek god, flying around all over Atlanta.
Cesaro now, not the top rope, but the top of the ring post. Now the top rope. Cross body lateral press. Sheamus kicks it too.
It's like one of those parkour kids on the internet doing stuff that's absurd. Off the top, onto the rope, slingshot cross body. Sheamus, eat a Cesaro, guys.
Who says that Ricochet is the only one that can fly around in this match? It could be time for the swing.
Sheamus might be flying around.
One, two, three. The WWE fans in unison.
11, 13, with just 22 of them.
Almost 15.
We almost saw him puke up Ryan Seacrest.
And now looking for the sharpshooter. Sharpshooter locked in. Is Sheamus going to tap?
Sheamus has no clue. He's in Atlanta. But he did find the rope there.
Sheamus makes it to the bottom rope, forcing the break.
Spinning, knowing that he has no tag team partner to tag in. Sheamus knows he's all by himself, and Cesaro is feasting like it's a Toblerone.
Yeah, and Sheamus was still out there running his mouth.
As he should. Sheamus has always been running. Whoa, 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 whoa.
Cesaro.
Quick like a cat.
Oh, big knee right to the face. Cover now by Sheamus. Ricochet breaking things up.
That's good tag team sports entertainment.
Rick to the midsection. Sheamus now looking to take Ricochet out.
Dude.
Both men over the top rope. Sheamus hits the floor. Hey, it's January. It's Rumble season. Might as well get a little preview. And now Sheamus with Ricochet on his shoulder. Oh, my goodness! White noise to the floor!
Looking like Michigan last night getting pounded into the ground.
Oh, and an uppercut by Cesaro. Cover now on Sheamus. Hook of the leg for the win, and Sheamus able to kick out.
Cesaro and Sheamus. These two used to drive town to town, beating people up together.
And that's what upset Cesaro about the whole thing. So Sheamus forgot all about it. Left with an injury, came back, and wanted nothing to do with Cesaro. Sheamus whipped into the corner. Nobody home. Cesaro, shoulder first of the power, bro kick! Cover by Sheamus! Under the line! Oh, Sheamus got him!
But we all know the performance Sheamus just put on should never be forgotten here.
Yeah, pretty impressive Celtic warrior tonight. And he really turned things around outside the ring when he took Ricochet out of the equation. Sheamus celebrated here at State Farm Arena, but here was white noise.
Ricochet took Rich Holland out earlier. Sheamus said, let me neutralize that. And then let me hit, boom!
The probe.
First win of 2020
Cesaro and Ricochet. What a spot.